Okay, next up, we've got someone who's really nervous. Okay? I'm so nervous, like, you know, I saw him, like, as soon as, you know, it's cold in here and he's in shorts and he's like, these are like, you know, going like, click, 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 click. Well, anyway, let's, hopefully your long hair is keeping you a little insulated. Amo!
Okay, so I hate doing this, but I'll still give a background to this. I was traveling into Maharashtra, the rural part of Maharashtra, and I observed something that moved me so much that I couldn't eat that night. And going by this, I really eat a lot. Yeah, right. So, we've all heard about Doodh Peeti or, you know, Doodh Peeti, where they dump the girl in the milk as soon as the girl is born. Female infanticide.
Yeah.
That's still okay. This was worse. They name her Nakusha after the girl is born. Nakusha means unwanted. And they believe that if they name the girl Nakusha, the next child would be a boy. It's that bad. So, here it is. The sweat seldom remained ignored. The screams were drowned in loud prayers. Her blood was worthless. She wasn't the first or second. Her life was life for none, but only a means for few. She screamed once more, praying against her will, as if she knew. Every breath came in short gasps, as if counting down. Her dream of a happy family shattered with every beep, and her soul split in two as they both inhaled venom. The doctor came bearing positive news, but alas, they knew. What he spoke did not matter, a life was famished. Inside, a mother was pleading, crying. The pain was only numb. She had brought shame. She would continue to wither. The child was a girl. Oh yes, that was a mistake. Whose? None knew, but all continued to blame. The mother-in-law resorted to fewer prayers and an ill-working talisman, while her husband said she wasn't the one. There was no ceremony, no lights, no frills, no hanging, singing congratulations. She was named Nakusha, and that shall be her identity. Unwanted, disregarded, cursed and condemned. Caustic, unschooled and execrated, she would wait for lights to fade. Her dining table was a stool not high enough. The same she used to take a bath, and the same she would sit on and stare. She would cry in darkness and sleep off on stiff rocks, awaiting the occasional love only from her mother's eyes. Her being was questioned every morning, her tears demanded answers from her voice. What wrong had been done? Why only her? Why millions after her? Whom to blame she did not know, but she did continue. She was raised, although crude, like a pig for slaughter. She was sent off to another cell, where the walls were chalk and the primus burnt fingers. Burned and tattered, her soul had died long ago. Here, too, none loved her. Love was so foreign. To her, only servants and slavery were friends. She too wasn't cared for. She too became a means. The prayers echoed again. She was bearing a soul now. She was happy to split hers. And as it started to bulge, her reason became stronger. She was a mother, her child's beats thundering inside her. It all ceased when a thought killed her on a stretcher. What if she's Nagusha?